A dog barks when his master is attacked. I would be a coward if I saw that God's truth is attacked and yet would remain silent. John Calvin.
Telling a woman that she can't be an elder is a nonsense rule. If they claim to be in the
body, we let them have it. Donald Trump is going to win in 2020 by an absolute landslide. Heretics Christianizing
the American dream. So you're allowing the devil with his diseases because you've sinned to attack you.
Sowing is a blessing from God to make you rich.
Being rich is like a lottery ticket.
The Lord spoke to my heart. Been very few times I've ever heard God be this articulate with me. And I'm telling you word for word, these words came into my heart. I'm not asking you to witness to him. I'm asking you to brush his hair. That's what God commanded.
Hey, welcome back to the Master's Dog False Teacher of the Week, episode 56. I'm your host, Norm, the Master's Dog Dunham, a.k.a. the Evangelical Norm. So, the Master's Dog False Teacher of the Week is a segment of the Master's Dog podcast that came out of necessity of the original introduction video, which was 2.5 minutes of a montage of about 40 false teachers set to a really cool song by Result, used by permission. Thank you, Result. And someone had come to me and said, I don't know who all these people are. I thought some of them were okay. Could you kind of break it down and let us know what is what? You know, who? Why are these people false teachers? And so I started with Stephen Furtick, which was who they had a question about. And then I systematically went through that introduction video and broke down each teacher that was in there. I added a couple of people who might not have been in there, the Pope and somebody else, but broke down why each one of them was a false teacher. And after I finished that, I shortened down the introduction video, used a new beat that I just made on my phone, and made a more versatile introduction video. I can insert and take out clips and stuff like that. So it's kind of a cool thing. And at this point, I could, if we get enough subscribers, apparently you have to have 1,000 subscribers on YouTube to be monetized. I'm really hoping at some point in time we can monetize, although I'm sure I'll say something that'll get me unmonetized quickly. But it's good to have goals, right? So all that, to change the intro video and so on. And so now we are continuing on with different false teachers. A lot of them have been by your request or suggestion. Some of them, they're just people that I've had on a list for a long time. Today is a guy that I've had on the list for a long time. And I don't know what it is about Jim Bakker that I have just not wanted to do anything about him. This guy has just been a thorn in the side of Christianity for way too long. He was exposed as a false teacher years ago, as a charlatan, a sexually immoral man, a disqualified as a pastor, preacher, anything, years ago in the early to mid 80s. So many things that went down about Jim. Let's take a look at just a few of them. Let's see, a few of the scandals in his career. So first off, there was a $279,000 payoff for the silence of Jessica Hahn, who alleged that Bakker and former Praise the Lord Club, PTL Club co-host John Wesley Fletcher drugged and raped her. She was paid with funds that were raised by supporters of the PTL Club. And so this was basically the first, well, no, I don't even think this was the first scandal. I think there were financial scandals that had come before, but this was the big thing. This is what caused him to actually step down. And then shortly afterwards, he ended up going to prison because of misuse of funds from the PTL club that were supposed to be used for different things that were not. I can't remember. There were so many things that came out. Apparently, there was like a $20,000 or maybe it was more. Maybe it was, I don't think it was 200,000. It was this astronomical number of a two-story air-conditioned doghouse that they had used ministry funds to pay for. So these are just all the things. And of course, he's out there. He's on the TV. He's coming up with excuses, telling people this is why you need to donate money. I don't think he was one of the ones that was like, God is going to take me home if I don't raise this much money. But he did use that. God told me to do this multiple times, putting himself in the place of a false prophet. But then, of course, scandal and money and so on. So those are all the basic things. Then he did go to prison. And let me see. Okay, so his fraud conviction, the PTL Club's fundraising activities between 1984 and 87 were reported by the Charlotte Observer, leading to criminal charges. Bakker and his associates sold $1,000 lifetime memberships, entitling buyers to an annual three-night stay at a luxury hotel at Heritage USA, which is apparently like a theme park that they had created. According to the prosecution of Bakker's fraud trial, tens of thousands of memberships were sold, but only one 500-room hotel was ever finished. So he sold these exclusive partnerships. After a 16-month federal grand jury probe, he was indicted in 88 on 8 counts of mail fraud, 15 counts of wire fraud, and 1 count of conspiracy. In 1989, after a 5-week trial that began on August 28th, jury found him guilty on all 24 counts, and he was sentenced to 45 years in federal prison and imposed a $500,000 fine. So, I'm trying to see here if I can find the date. The sentence reduction hearing was held on November 16th, 1992. Baker's sentence was reduced to 8 years. In 93, he was transferred to a minimum security federal prison, and he was paroled in 1994. So that's when he got out. Remarried, apparently, I mean, if Tammy Faye Bakker is going to leave you, right? So, remarried another lady. I honestly don't know her name, and I didn't take the time to actually look for it. I know it's in here somewhere and among all these things about him. But in 2003, he started to rebroadcast. And this is, again, this is the thing that gets me about these false teachers, especially him and, like, Peter Popov. People are And I hate to say this, but there are people that are so gullible, that are so willing to be defrauded, by these false teachers, these men who will stop at nothing to blaspheme, one, the name of the Lord, to use the God and I can't even say the gospel, because I don't know that any of these men actually know the gospel, but to use those things as a con to take people's money. And they both, I mean, Peter Popov, and I did an episode on him a long time ago, but both of them exposed in their false teachings, exposed in their charlatanism, is that a word? It is now. And then both of them returned to televangelism after, you know, a period of time, and people apparently are willing to let them back in. Most recently, the things with Jim Bakker and what brought him kind of back into my lens, I guess. I don't know what word I'm looking for. Onto my radar. That's what I'm trying to say. What brought him back onto my radar was at the beginning of the COVID-19 pandemic, he started selling colloidal silver. It's a supplement. that supposedly is a panacea that will cure anything. And there are people who took a lot of it. And I mean, literally, there's a guy out there that took so much of this colloidal silver that he turned blue. Like Papa Smurf, man. And so Jim was selling these supplements and trying to tell people they would cure them of COVID-19 and all coronaviruses and so on. So he was sued by the Attorney General of New York. He was offered to cease and desist, making medicinal claims. And so, I mean, just all kinds of stuff. He was prohibited from receiving credit card transactions, all these things. And lovely, there's an alarm. I thought I'd shut that off. So all these things. And then more recently, and this actually proved to be untrue, but somebody had posted that on Twitter, he had said apparently in an interview or something that God can't hear your prayers through masks. Now, I'm not a mask guy. I don't like masks. I don't care for masks. I don't wear masks often. But, I mean, that's a ridiculous statement. And unfortunately, I mean, even in this sense, you know, as there are some places where Jim Bakker won't even go to make a statement. But I was glad to see that it was not true. But he's made so many false claims, so many false prophecies. I mean, there's a list of just false prophecies that he has made over the years, things that he said was going to happen if this didn't do happen, blah, blah, blah. And I mean, all of this stuff, it's the prosperity gospel. It is, you give so much to this ministry and God is going to give so much back to you and blah, 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 blah. And it's just, it takes the gospel and it twists it into, as the intro, the little clip from Shylin in there where they're treating Jesus like a lottery ticket is what they literally do. They're like, here's your deal. If you do this, than this. It's a Christianized version of The Secret. And that's, we're going to get to that next week. Rhonda Byrne is going to be our false teacher next week. So there's a little teaser for you with The Secret. But literally the majority of, and that, I mean, that's just a twisting of sowing and reaping and that principle that we see in the Bible. But again, they take it and they twist it in order to make themselves rich. And that is, it's blasphemous. It is literally blasphemous to take God's word and twist it for your own illicit intentions to make yourself rich. And that's what these men did. So many of them in the early 80s, so much that there was a significant detectable drop in giving to churches because of a lack of trust during this time period. And to this day, you'll see there that comparatively to what churches took in the, you know, 50s, 60s, and 70s, there's a significant drop after the 80s because people began to mistrust whether or not churches were what they were doing with that money. Obviously, there are churches where it doesn't affect because people, I mean, the gospel is preached and pastors are trusted. But when you still get into these large mainstream churches, the giving significantly decreased and it can correlate almost directly to the scandals of Swaggart, Bakker, and men like that during the early 1980s. And so, again, this is what makes this man a false teacher, and the fact that he's still out there today with a TV show and people are willing to send money to that ministry is just a testimony to the what's the word I'm looking for? Deception, but the charismatic deception that these men are able to and essentially it's a con. They're con men, and they're able to play this out on so many people who become their marks and are willing to give because of a belief of some sort in that prosperity gospel, which is so unfortunate because it has nothing to do with what the real gospel of Jesus Christ is, and the fact that Jesus came, died, and paid the penalty for our sin, so that if we would repent and put our trust in Him, that He would forgive us of our sin. And none of that has anything to do with monetary gain, with physical health, with anything other than the forgiveness of sin. That's what the gospel is about. That is what should be preached. And that is what makes men like Jim Bakker false teachers, heretics, blasphemers, you name it. You pick your terminology. Men who are not to be followed and not to be trusted. All right. So, and there we go again. Live podcasting, y'all. I will get that shut off before I record another video. So thanks, guys, for taking the time to watch. Please, if you haven't already, hit the like button, hit the share button. That makes Mr. Algorithm send these videos out to more and more people who might be interested in watching these. If you haven't subscribed, we've had a bunch of subscribers recently. So if you haven't subscribed already, please hit that subscribe button, hit the notification button. You'll get all the content that I release here on the Evangelical Norm YouTube channel, all the different podcasts. Let me tell you, The Master's Dog, The Fifth Seal, Unsolicited, all of those podcasts that I do on the different topics and so on, you'll get all that. And, of course, live episodes of Stupid Things Jory Micah Says, which is always fun. So, again, thank you guys for taking the time to watch. As always, preach the gospel at all times. Use words. They're necessary. And until next time, Soli Deo Gloria.